For the light chain amyloidosis, we give them diuretics to get rid of the excess fluid and, you know, improve their symptoms of shortness of breath, which is due to accumulation of fluid in the heart. For the transthyretin amyloidosis, the management is also focused on heart failure as well as the specific cause. We give them diuretics, we give them anticoagulation to decrease stroke risk, and the management also involves care and attention to medications.
As pharmacists, what we do in relation to cardiac amyloidosis is once we realize that we have a diagnosis of cardiac amyloidosis on our hands, we work very quickly to get the correct medications selected and approved so that patients can get access to these medications as quickly as possible. We know that the best outcomes happen when we can get patients on medications as quickly as possible after diagnosis, so we really take it upon ourselves to work as quickly as we can.
So one of the medications that we really work with on an intimate basis in the cardiology clinic is called tafamidis. This medication is FDA approved to treat both hereditary and wild type ATTR. Tafamidis is a medication that's given orally once a day, so it's a really convenient option for our patients. And the randomized controlled trials for this medication have really shown that it's very well tolerated, so very minimal side effects, which again make it a convenient option for our patient population.
You can further treat the transthyretin amyloidosis with a group of drugs that we call fibril disruptors. This includes a combination of doxycycline and taurodeoxycholic acid. Even the green tea extract is useful as a fibril disruptor.